guys, I'm back with another makeup tutorial. So it's about time that I did a vampy lip. This is truly a vampy lip. This is something I just wore out one day and I was trying to feel like in the winter season. So I started out by priming my face with a little bit of rose water. Then I'm doing my eyes. They're pretty simple. Just a little bronzer on my crease. The same bronzer I use on my face from MAC. I believe it's the Give Me Sun Mineralized Skin Finish. And the lid is going to be pretty nude. I'm using this Myron Neutral Palette, a mix of white and cream. And I'm giving like a very nude matte lid. So I'm packing that on with a flat brush and getting it very light. And then I'm going to keep the outside corner a little bit smoky, but still neutral. So I tend to use warm tones, but here I'm using like a taupe just to kind of give like a shadowy effect. I didn't really want to put a lot of emphasis on the eyes because it would be mainly on the lips. So I'm using my favorite Universal Blender brush from Pseudo and Lace. That's part of my Vortex set. And I'm creating kind of like that winged outer V shape. And I told you that eyeshadow is very simple. So what I like to do is once I finish most of my eyeshadow, I go to the brows. So that way I can not mess up the brows with blending and all that stuff. So I'm using this NYX Brow Micro Brow Pencil in Brunette, which is really nice. It's affordable. I love the precision. And then because I don't really have a lot going on my eye, I want to make sure the brows are very neat. So I don't always conceal around the brows, but this time I am. And I believe I'm using the It Cosmetics Bye Bye Under Eye Concealer. This little teeny brush is from, I think, a Mayron or Krylon paint palette, but it's really precise and stiff, so it's nice. Then I'm setting that concealer with the nude creamy tone from that Mayron Neutral Palette. So this is why I do brows second. I do my eyeshadow, then the brows, then I conceal, that's my highlight, then the brow highlight. And then I like to bring my crease up to the brow bone. So easy, right? So this is really something that I would wear on an everyday basis, not really just like for YouTube or Instagram. So I concealed underneath my eyes, and now I'm using, what foundation was that? MAC Waterweight Foundation. So it's been a minute since I used it. I'm a little paler right now, so this NC42 color is my winter shade. I'm putting it on with an It Cosmetics brush. I always dampen my brushes with a little bit of rose water or setting spray because it makes the foundation a little bit more sheer, and I like a little bit more of a medium coverage. So I'm blending this all over very fast. And now I'm going to highlight. So I want to keep my skin kind of dewy. So this is the It Cosmetics Illuminating Bye Bye Under Eye Concealer in, I think, medium. So it has a little bit of a shimmer to it. It is a little bit, like, pinky. I prefer more of a yellow highlight, but because this has a shimmer, I don't mind it so much. So I place that on all my highlight areas. And now I'm taking this Makeup Bullet sponge with a little bit, dampened it a little bit. Can you see a theme? I dampen all of my tools and it really makes everything sheer out and apply super dewy. And especially because it's like winter, when my skin's dry, a little moisture is a good thing. So I'm using this to pat in that highlight. I got this sponge from iMats Atlanta. Shout out to Eva Buckley and her amazing line. So yep, just tapping it in. As you can see, it is a little bit more dewy. Following up with a setting powder from Cover FX, their Illuminating Setting Powder and Light. I didn't want to take away the glossy effect of that under eye concealer, so I'm using more of an illuminating setting powder. This one is really pretty. It's been like a favorite for years. For the rest of the face, I don't want to add coverage or color, so I'm just using the It Cosmetics. I think it's their pore filling powder. And now I'm bronzing that face back up with the same color I put in my crease, which is a MAC Give Me Sun Mineralized Skin Finish. That giant brush is an old brush from MAC, but it makes bronzer fast, 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 fast. All right, so back to a little bit more contour. Now I'm using a smaller brush. This is my Dome Contour Brush from Sedona Lace. I use it to get a deeper color so that way I can really chisel the cheeks. The bronze color was for a tan. This color is actually for shaping and skinnying up my face. So two levels, a lighter bronzer and then a little deeper or darker. For the nose, I go for more of a cool shade. This is like taupe because I hate the look of like a warm line on your nose from like contour. It's just not, it doesn't look real. You need more of a shadowy tone on your nose. And then I'm going to use some cream blush. So this is again, I think from Mayron. Mayron has amazing products, by the way. Like, I don't think they get talked about enough. So I'm using this orange tone blush because I do want to keep the glow and the warmth to the skin. I notice when you do really vampy dark lips, sometimes if you don't add the bronze back into the skin, you can look a little bit vampirish. So that's why I'm emphasizing the warm tones on my skin. So this is a cream blush, so you have to be very subtle with it and then blend it in because you don't want to overpower it. So I'm using that that wet sponge again to help blend it in. So blend as much as you can. It looks a little harsh here, but I'm telling you it's going to come together. So one of the tips that I always tell people to do is that if you feel like you didn't blend your contour, your blush, your highlight enough, go over it with a little translucent powder and that will kind of help you blend. So back to the eyes, because now that I have my under eye concealer done, I can go ahead and put my liner on the bottom. There's no point in doing your eyes if you're going to come back in with concealer. So I put a brown pencil there, and it's from Illamasqua, like a reddish brown. I love it. And now I'm smoking that lash line out with one of the darker contour shades in that same Rocky Cosetti palette. So because my top lid is kind of nude, I decided to smoke the bottom out a little bit more. And this is a little teeny crease brush also from Cosetti brushes. So it's an option. You know, you don't always have to focus on the top. You can do a little bit more on the bottom. And I brought that bottom shadow all the way up to the top, like as if to do a wing. Just make sure the bottom shadow on the lower lash line isn't too thick, because then it kind of closes your eyes off. So now I'm using Pixie Beauty liquid liner. I love this one. This is from the Pixie times Whaley collab. It is like really, really good. Then a little bit of mascara. Honestly, I do this just so that way it blends into my falsies, because I put falsies every single time I do makeup. And I believe these are the You Complete Me Lash from Velour Lashes. I think it's so funny because, like, back in the day, I used to always wear lashes in my tutorials, and I used to think that I was doing too much, but now everybody does it too, so it's normal now. So I'm just blending everything out a little bit more. Like I said, I'm taking that bottom wing from my lower lash line up into my top wing so everything blends. So very simple but very pretty. And now all we have to do is lips. So I'm starting out with a dark lip liner. This is from Iman Cosmetics. And it's just a very dark browny, kind of chocolatey, reddish brown. MAC Chestnut would be a really good option. Anything that's dark like this. So you need a lip liner when you do a vampy lip, because it helps you make it much more neat and much more perfect looking. So now I'm going to take this Dose of Colors liquid lipstick. I believe it's called Black Dahlia or Black Cherry. It's really vampy, and it's like one of the first liquid lipsticks I actually ever bought. So it's kind of a little bit hard to work with. I don't know if it's getting old, but I'm spreading this out and I'm kind of blending it into that Iman dark liner. So I outlined and now I'm filling in. And once that's nice and evenly applied, I finish it up with a little bit more of that lip liner. I do this all the time. I apply lip liner first, then the lip color, and then I go back in with that lip liner. This will ensure that your lip liner is super neat and you can kind of even any mistakes out. So when you have the lip product on too, the lip liner blends easier the third time around. So I'm finishing up with a little bit of Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector in Opal. Again, I'm bringing the dew back to my skin. I love liquid illuminators lately. I think they just look healthier than powders, and they look a lot more seamless and natural. So I'm just kind of placing those on the high points of my face, also on my eyebrows. I just kind of went crazy with it. So this brings the light back to my face. And, oh, a little tear ducts too. Girl, I went everywhere with this. But I'm just using my fingertips to blend it in, because the heat from my fingers will melt into the skin. So this is the final look. I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know if you recreate it. Tag me. And until next time, have a great night. Ciao, Bellas.